Everybody wants to be number one in Google. Google has to pick somebody to be number one. What happens if two companies are equally matched, like Coke and Pepsi? If they're equally matched on by every metric you could think of, if they both have the same customer base, they both taste about the same, they both use the same Madison Avenue advertising agencies, they both advertise in the Super Bowl, Google has to pick one. What a lot of people don't understand about Google is that the algorithm that decides who gets to be number one has more to do with external websites than it does with your website. Customers will come to us and they'll have a website and they'll say, I'll make my website number one in Google. And the method to do that is I create dozens, if not hundreds, of extra websites to support their main website. If both of these are equal, but only one guy can be number one. You know, if somebody's number one, that means somebody else is in second place. The way the algorithm works is called PageRank. It's actually patented. It's a play on words because the guy that developed it, his name was Larry Page. Pages are ranked by according to how many other websites have their link on them. If another website has your link on it, in essence, that website has voted for you. If Coke.com has 1,200,000 external websites that mention Coke, Coca-Cola, or Coke.com for it, that is, in effect, 1.5 million votes for Coke.com. If Pepsi has 3.2 million other websites that mention Pepsi, Pepsi.com, or have the link Pepsi.com, Pepsi wins, even though they're both equally matched. I can't tell the difference between the two of them. If I had a blindfolded taste test, I wouldn't be able to tell you which one was Coke, which one was Pepsi.